All right, now cutting across to all the war of words that's currently panning out in Kerala on CPIM, where CPM Thrissur accounts have been frozen. That's what the Kerala CPIM party says. In fact, they've attacked the BJP for it. Pinraya Vijayan says the BJP is resorting to cheap politics. Tax department freezes the CPIM's accounts. Local unit bank accounts has been frozen. IT department says the CPIM didn't show the account annual returns, and therefore this is only as per protocols and as per the law. They have frozen the account temporarily. Now, remember, this was a similar allegation that was made even by the Congress party, where they claimed that their accounts, party accounts, were frozen by the IT department over cases that went on years old. Years old cases were brought in right in time for Lok Sabha elections. Just before elections could begin, their accounts have been frozen. Similar allegation now by the India Bloc ally, the CPIM, saying in Thrissur, their local accounts, the party's accounts, have been frozen. While you have the income tax department saying it was the fault of the CPIM party, they have not shown their annual returns, therefore this is only mandate. Let me cut across to Shibi Mol KG, joining us more on that. Shibi? All right, I'm going to cut across to Pinraya Vijayan, who's spoken right on this issue. Let me first take that bite.
സിപിഎമ്മിന്റെ അക്കൗണ്ട് മരവിപ്പിച്ചാൽ ഇവിടെ സുരേഷ് ഗോപിക്ക് വല്ല രക്ഷയും കിട്ടും എന്നുള്ളൊരു ആലോചന സ്വാഭാവികമായിട്ട് ബി ജെ പിക്ക് ഉണ്ടാകാം. ഞങ്ങളുടെ കയ്യിൽ കുറച്ച് കാശ് എല്ലാ കാലത്തും ഉണ്ടാകാറുണ്ട്. അത് രഹസ്യമല്ല. അത് ഇന്ത്യ ഗവൺമെന്റിന് കൊടുക്കുന്ന കണക്കിലും ഞങ്ങൾ വ്യക്തമാക്കുന്ന കാര്യമാണ്. സാധാരണ നിലക്ക് തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് പ്രവർത്തനം ഞങ്ങൾ നടത്തുന്നത് ജനങ്ങൾ നൽകുന്ന സംഭാവന ഉപയോഗിച്ചാണ്. ആ വശം തടയാൻ ഒരു കൂട്ടർക്കും കഴിയില്ല. ബി ജെ പിയെ പോലെ വൻപിച്ച തോതിൽ പണമൊന്നും ചെലവഴിക്കാൻ ഞങ്ങൾക്കാവില്ല. പക്ഷേ ആവശ്യമായ തെരഞ്ഞെടുപ്പ് ഉപചരണങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഞങ്ങൾ നടത്താറുണ്ട്. അതിപ്പോ ഇവിടെയും നടത്തുന്നുണ്ട്.
Let me cut across to Shibi Mol KG, joining us live for more on that. Shibi, similar allegations of what the Congress party had made, saying that their accounts have been frozen right before Lok Sabha elections, echoed by the CPIM as well. Their bank accounts in Thrissur have been frozen. Is that right? And what's been the response of the IT department on that?
Well, Nabila, the one bank account of the CPM Thrissur District Committee has been frozen by the income tax around a week ago. In fact, they carried out a few inspections also before freezing the account, saying that the returns of this particular account was not filed by the party, and that's why we freezed it. There are around 4.8 crore rupee in that account when the account was freezed, and the CPM District Committee was given a direction by the income tax not to withdraw any money further. Now, that time itself, the CPM has said that if it is an attempt to ensure that your candidate will win from Thrissur constituency, then it's not happening, was what the CPM had responded. This is the first time the Chief Minister Pinraya Vijayan is speaking on the issue, you know, hitting out at the BJP on, in the background of Prime Minister Modi yesterday speaking on the Karvanur bank scam also in Thrissur. Now, CM is saying that if you feel that Suresh Gopi, the BJP candidate from Thrissur, can win the constituency by doing this to us, then it's not happening. He also goes on to say that we do have few money, we do have you know, certain assets which is known to everybody, every party has, just like that we also have, and mostly the campaign of CPM is carried out by collecting money from the local public. So he says that we've done it in the past, we'll continue to do that. Even if we don't have enough money as a party like BJP, we'll continue to take out the campaign very well effectively, and no ED or CBI can you know, touch us or ensure that we take a back seat in the Lok Sabha elections. Remember, the ED is also investigating the Karvanur bank scam in Thrissur itself, where a lot of CPM leaders, the local CPM leaders, are under the ED scan. A lot of them have been questioned by the ED already. So the CPM here is strongly raising this narrative that the central agencies here are being used time and again to target the opposition parties, and it's not less than the same thing that's happening again to the CPM in Kerala.
Thanks very much, Shibi, for joining us with those details.